Hello students, so welcome back to your online sessions. I hope you all are fine at your homes. Students, as you know that we have finished with the half yearly exams and you all know that how you have performed in your half yearlies. Now again you are going to get your assignments and you all know that you are going to get marks based on these assignments only, depending on how regular and how timely you submit your assignment. So be regular and send your assignments on time. Okay, so let's get started. Class 4th, we are starting your chapter number 10, that is metric measure. In this chapter, we are going to learn measurement of length, weight or mass and capacity. Okay, we will learn how to measure the length, weight and capacity of an object. Also, we will learn the conversion of units. Okay, so first, we are going to learn the measurement of length. So in this, the standard unit of length is meter. To measure the length of any object, what standard unit we use, that is meter. And in short, meter is written as m. Now there are some more units of length, that is kilometer, hectometer and decameter. These units are greater than the standard unit, that is meter. It means kilometer, hectometer and decameter are greater than meter. And the units decimeter, centimeter and millimeter are smaller than meter. Okay, so this kilo, hecto and deca are greater than meter and deci, centi and milli are smaller than meter. Okay, the most commonly used units of length are kilometer, meter and centimeter. And the most commonly used units are kilometer, meter and centimeter. Usually, centimeter is used to measure short length, like the length of this pen marker or the length of your pencil. Meter is used to calculate the long length, like length of your car, length of a sari, and short distance, like distance of from your kitchen to your bedroom. Okay, and kilometer is used to measure very long distance, like distance from your home to your school or distance from your home to your village. These are calculated in kilometer. So before starting your conversion of unit, there are some relationship between different units of length with meter. Okay, here we are just learning the relationship of different unit with meter. Okay, so first we have units of length that are greater than meter. So I told you that decameter, hectometer and kilometer are greater than meter. Okay, so what is the relation between decameter and meter? That one decameter is equals to 10 meters. Decameter in short is written as DAM, okay, and meter as M. So 1 decameter is equals to 10 meters. It means in 1 decameter there are 10 meters. Clear? Next is your 1 hectometer. So 1 hectometer is equals to 100 meters. It means in 1 hectometer there are 100 meters. Hectometer in short is written as HM and meter is M. Okay. Next you are having 1 kilometer. Kilometer in short form is written as small k and small m. Km is equals to 1000 meters. It means in 1 kilometer there are 1000 meters. Okay. So these are the units of length which are greater than meter. Now we are having units of length smaller than meter. So 1 meter is equals to 10 decimeter. Okay, decimeter, centimeter and millimeter, these are the units of length which are smaller than meter. So 1 meter is equals to 10 decimeter. The short form of decimeter is dm. Next, 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter. It means in 1 meter there are 100 centimeter, and centimeter in short is written as cm. Last is your 1 meter is equals to 1000 millimeter, and millimeter in short form is written as mm. Okay. Now we are having conversion from bigger to smaller units. We will learn conversion of bigger units into smaller units. Okay. So you can see that here I have written the units of length in descending order. First one is your kilometer, then hectometer, then decameter, then meter, decimeter, centimeter and millimeter. Okay, now just keep one thing in mind, that whenever you have to convert a greater unit into a smaller, for example, I have to convert meter into centimeter, meter is a bigger unit and centimeter is a smaller. You can see meter is lying over here. So meter is a bigger unit and centimeter is a smaller unit. And I told you that 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter. This I told you. So whenever you have to convert a bigger unit into smaller unit, what you will do? You will do multiply. Okay, so if you have to convert meter into centimeter, you will multiply that number by 100. Okay, for example, I told you to convert 12 meter into centimeter. Okay, here meter is a bigger unit and centimeter is a smaller. So what you will do, you will write 12 meter is equals to 12 into 100 centimeter. Why you have multiply? I told you whenever you have to convert a bigger unit into a smaller, you will do multiplication. And why you have multiplied with 100? Because I told you that 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter. So it becomes your 1200 centimeter. Clear? Now your first question is convert 4 kilometer 250 meter into meters. You have to convert this 4 kilometer 250 meter into meters. So you will write 4 kilometer 250 meter. Okay, you have to convert them into meters. Now you can see this 250 is already in meter. So no need of converting it. Now come to this 4 kilometer. Now you have to convert this kilometer into meter. Kilometer is a bigger unit. Meter is a smaller unit. It means you have to multiply. So you will write 4 multiply. Now by what number you are going to multiply? It is very easy. Now come to this line. Okay. We learn it as KHDMDCM. Okay. Now you have to convert this kilometer into meter. Now how many steps you are taking? 1, 2, 3. How many steps you have taken? 1, 2, 3. It means you have to multiply this 4 with 1000. 3 zeros. Why 3 zeros? Because you have taken 3 steps. Okay. Plus this 250. Why I am adding this 250? Because 250 is already in meter. Okay. 250 is already in meter. So I have converted this 4 kilometer into meter by multiplying it with 1000. So it becomes 4000 plus 250. Bracket close and you will write a meter over here. Okay, now add them. It will become 4250 meter, and this will be your answer. Okay, you can do it like this also, or you can learn like that. I have told you that 1 kilometer is equals to 1000 meter. Okay, 1 kilometer is equals to 1000 meter. So you will write 4 kilometer 250 meter is equals to 4 into 1000 plus 250 meter. And when you solve it, you are getting 4250 meter. Okay. So both the methods are correct. If you are able to learn these, that is very good. But suppose you are not able to learn these, you can do it like this also. Okay. Just write down this table. That is kilometer, hectometer, decameter, meter, decimeter, centimeter and millimeter. And just count the steps. If you have to convert kilometer into meter, how many steps you have taken? 1, 2, 3. 3 steps. It means you have to multiply that number by 1000. And if you are able to learn that 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter, that is very good. And you can solve it like this also. Okay. Your next question is, question number 2 is, convert 14 centimeter into millimeter. Now you have to convert this 14 centimeter into millimeter. Again, centimeter is a bigger unit, millimeter is a smaller. It means you have to do multiplication. And we know that 1 centimeter is equals to 10 millimeter. So you will write 14 centimeter is equals to 14 into 10 millimeter, and it will be 140 millimeter. Again, I'm telling you that if you are not able to learn this, many times you got confused. So what you will do, you will make this table. You have to convert this centimeter into millimeter. Now how many steps you have taken? One step means you have to multiply it with 10, and your answer will be 140 millimeter. This will be your answer. Okay. Now next we are having conversion from smaller to bigger units. When I told you that when we have to convert a bigger unit into a smaller, we do multiplication, and whenever you have to convert a smaller unit into a bigger, what you do? You will be doing division. Okay? So here you have to convert this 65 millimeter into centimeter, and we know that 1 centimeter is equals to 10 millimeter. This I told you before. So it means for converting this 65 millimeter into centimeter, what you do? You divide this 65 by 10. Why you are dividing? Because you are converting a smaller unit into a greater unit. And why you are dividing it by 10? Because 1 centimeter is equals to 10 millimeter. Okay? So, start dividing it. I am doing the division over here. So, when you divide this 65 by 10, what you got? 10, 6 are 60. Okay? And 5 minus 0, 5 will be as it is. The 6 minus 0, 6 minus 6 will be 0. So, what you are getting? You are getting 6 as a quotient. Okay? So, this 6 become the greater unit. It means it becomes 6 centimeter. And 5 is your remainder. 5 millimeter. And this will be your answer. Clear? Divide them. The part, the quotient part. This is your quotient part. The quotient part become your bigger unit. Okay? Here centimeter is a bigger unit, so it becomes 6 centimeter, and this will be your smaller, that is 5 millimeter. Okay? 2 is convert 235 millimeter into centimeter and millimeter. Now you have to convert this 235 millimeter into centimeter and millimeter. Now I told you that 1 centimeter is equals to 10 millimeter. It means you have to divide this with 10. So you will write this is equals to 235 divided by 10 millimeter. Clear? Or I told you, if you are not able to remember this, now see, you have to convert this millimeter into centimeter. How many steps you have taken? 1. It means you have to divide it by 10. So here I have done the division. So 10 dividing 235. So 10 twos are 20. Okay, 3 minus 0 will be 3, 2 minus 2 will be 0. Now you are going to copy this 5 over here. Okay, now 10, 3's are 30, and then 5, and this will be 0. Now what is your quotient? 23. So I told you the quotient part become the greater unit. It means it become, I am writing it over here, 23 centimeter, and this is your remainder, smaller part, that is 5 millimeter, and this will be your answer. Clear? So practice these kinds of questions and take care of yourself. Thank you.